Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Good evening, and may God bless you. Pastor Jamie Green here from the Gospel Spreading Church. Thank you for joining us for another nightly service of our period of fasting and prayer. This is our fall revival that we are seeking the Lord in a new and different way. We are so glad that the Lord has blessed us with the theme of this year, Running the Race with Purpose. Amen. And we're grateful that the Lord has blessed us to refocus on that theme this 10 days. I pray that you have been able to be with us because we have really heard the Holy Spirit speak to our hearts. And if by chance you did not get a chance to hear every service, we have good news. All is not lost. You go to the Gospel Spreading Church YouTube channel, everyone is there. So we just ask that you make a visit to that channel to hear what the Spirit has to say unto your church. We're going to ask Deacon Eric Smith if he would take us to the throne of grace. Deacon Eric?
Amen. Bless you. Let us bow our heads for a word of prayer. O righteous Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this day. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to come and spread the news to Heavenly Father. We ask you, Lord, to bless this service to Heavenly Father as we go through, Lord, during this period of fasting and praying. Lord, we thank you for all those that have come forth and broke the bread of life to Heavenly Father, that we may be encouraged to hold on until the end. Lord, we ask you to remember the speaker tonight to Heavenly Father. Bless him to Heavenly Father, that you may get all the glory to Heavenly Father. Lord, we ask you just to reach down and touch his body, touch his mind to Heavenly Father, that he may deliver the word to Heavenly Father that we all need. And Lord, remember those that may be sick in their bed of affliction to Heavenly Father. Lord, we ask you just to touch them to Heavenly Father, wherever they may be. And Lord, we just ask you to pour out your spirit to Heavenly Father, that souls may be saved. And Lord, we ask these blessings in your precious Son, Jesus' name, and let the church say, amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Deacon Eric. We are so grateful that you have joined us, and we just want to recap very quickly for you what the Lord has done this week. Throughout these 10 days, we have began on last Friday, and you know, for a while, we haven't been able to have services every night, but praise God for this virtual environment, because the Lord has afforded us the opportunity to have a service each one of the 10 days of fasting and prayer. And we thank God, amen, for every one of you who have chosen to be with us. And a special thank you for those who chose to be with us every night. On last Friday evening, we heard from Elder Waverly Charity, and his thought for us was stay in the race. The race isn't given to the swift or the strong, but the one that endures to the end. This past Saturday, Pastor Matthew Thompson encouraged us, don't let nothing cause you to turn your back on the Lord. You know, there's trials and tribulations that comes every day of our life, but don't let anything separate you from the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We thank God for our bishop last Sunday, breaking down, run the race with purpose, and how he encouraged us to have the purpose in mind of the race that we're running in, to know that we're not running for no reason, but we're running for the glory and honor of the Lord. Last Monday, Elder Anthony Bex from Washington, D.C., amen, he shared a thought with us, one another experience. Amen. And we're certainly glad for how God has placed us together for one another. Amen. And we're grateful for how he has given us a purpose as a body to help one another. Amen. On this past Tuesday, we thank God for interim pastor Alfonso Holt. Amen. And his thought was, he tripped me when people hurt you. Oh, my. Amen. That got a little close for some of us. Amen. Wow. Because sometimes it's really encouraging how all of these sermons tie together to hold on and don't give up no matter what comes your way. Challenges are going to come. Amen. But don't lose hope. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. This past Wednesday, Elder Anthony Hurst from Philadelphia shared love, the energy of spiritual gifts. Amen. And he shared with us how every motive that we have has to be rooted in the love. And it was as that love was expressed to us by our Lord and Savior, God's Son, Jesus yes. Christ. And if we don't act, react, and serve in love, as the scripture says, we are as a sounding brass and a tinkling cymbal. This past Thursday, Elder Tommy Smith encouraged us, prevailing winds. Amen. How we can be shifted to, but how the word encourages us not to be shifted to and fro by the prevailing winds of our society. Amen. But we keep attacking and keep on course. Amen. The race that's set before us. And on last evening, Pastor Richard Smith shared a better way. And my friends, amen, he really encouraged us not to be conformed to this world's pattern, but we need to show a better way because we do have a better way. And our better way is anchored in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Now, amen, we want you to share along with us as we go to this Holy Scripture, amen, to repeat the scripture that we have been given to us for the period of fasting and prayer, beginning at Joel, the second chapter, beginning at verse number 15. If you could read along with me, blow yes. the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call yes. a solemn assembly, gather the people, sanctify the congregation, assemble the elders, gather the children, and those that suck the breasts. Let the bridegroom go forth of his chamber, and the bride out of her closet. Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Lord, and give not the inheritance to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where's their God? Then will the Lord be jealous for his land and pity his people. We're going to go down to verse number 28. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons, your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions, and also upon the servants and upon the handmaids. In those days will I pour out my spirit. May the Lord ever bless the reading of his holy word. Amen. As a message from our bishop, he's not able to be on with us this evening, but he asks, solicit your prayers. Amen. That his strength will regain. So he's with us. Amen. On tomorrow, if the Lord be willing. We're thankful for the pastors who are logging in to encourage. Amen. The speaker of the hour. Amen. And we look forward to hearing Elder Woods lead us in intercessory prayer at the end of the, amen, after the message. So Elder Woods, amen. At the end of the message, we're going to have you lead us in intercessory prayer. And my friends, I am so excited for what the Lord is about to do for you. And most of all, what God is about to do for me. We're about to hear a rhema. We're about to hear a word that is coming from heaven, God's lips to our heart. And I hope you're ready to hear what the Spirit has to say unto your church. The title of our lesson for today is Help Wanted. Jesus wants you. Our speaker of the moment, of the day, of the hour is Elder Timothy Taylor, Evangelist Timothy Taylor from Bowie and Washington, D.C. We're so glad that he will be using his gifting, amen, for, amen, the kingdom of God. So without any further ado, amen, I'm going to mute and turn my camera off, amen, and give over to Evangelist Timothy Taylor. Elder Taylor?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Praise God. Thank you. Good evening, family of God, people of God, saints of God. I just wanted to come to you to let you know that my mission and assignment this evening is not to preach a good sermon, but Lord, use me as your messenger with an evangelist gift to preach and live a sermon that will deliver the goods of the gospel and help equip the saints of God in times like these. We are reminded in St. John, to me, 12 and 32, it says, "And I, if I be lifted up from the earth, will draw all men unto me." The Lord gave me Ephesians 4, 11 and 12. And it says, it talks about diversity of the spiritual gifts. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. You know, I want to take a brief moment and just encourage the missionaries and the disciples who are already in the field, who are working and spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. Keep running and keep working. It's all worth it, and you will be rewarded on that great day. Let us pray. Father God, Lord, as you've given a message, help want it. Jesus wants you. We ask you, Father God, to anoint these lips of clay and allow your servant to speak a word through the Holy Spirit that will give new life, that will encourage and comfort someone today. Draw them to the cross. And I pray that your word will bless your people in a bountiful way. Lord, I take no credit for what you are about to do and what you're going to do. I give you, Lord, all the glory, the honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, Holy Spirit, have your way. Amen. I look to myself and the Lord gave the title. It says, Help Wanted. Jesus wants you. Help Wanted. Jesus wants you. Well, the Lord began to speak and break that thing down to me. He said, look, it's Saturday. Wow. And Evangelist Tim Taylor is in service. Wow, what a change. Lord, what a change. Because guess what? Just like me, just like you, we all had to come to the Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ one day. Oh, okay, that's right. You've been perfect and saved all your life. Not. The word of God says, Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And guess what I want you to know? Jesus knows your past, he knows your present, and he knows your future. We all had stuff, we all had troubles, we all had issues, but God is saying today, guess what? Help wanted. And Jesus wants you. If you're running the race, he wants you to continue to run and keep running, but don't run by yourself, but help somebody else along the way. See, we must learn how to pluck out self, and self must die daily. The word of God reminds us, this is the church of God, gospel spreading, willingly Jesus suffered for our victory. And guess what he had to pluck out? He had to pluck out self-pride. He had to pluck out self-righteousness. He had to pluck out backbiting. He had to pluck out backsliding. He had to pluck out gossiping, lying, drinking, cursing, drugging, stealing, slipping, sliding, sinking, creeping, peeping, your thoughts. But guess what? He still wants us today to come to the cross. And some of us, yes, I said some of us, he had to reach way down for. And yet, when he reached way down and snatched us up and out of the miry clay, guess what? He saved a wretch like me. I can look at my own mirror and say, thank God for the change, because I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Can you say to yourself today, thank God for your change? And Jesus is saying, help wanted. And guess what? He wants you to come help spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. And now Jesus is saying, we as believers must live our lives and run our race, having strong faith and being faithful, knowing all roads lead to the cross and the blood of Jesus Christ. Now, we have to help equip the saints and others with the word of God and love of Jesus Christ, and be ready and be prepared to receive the lost, receive those who don't know Jesus Christ. And yet we have to be prepared with the love of Jesus Christ. Even when your unsaved children and family members begin to say, I surrender all, I need some help, they ask the question, who is this man named Jesus? You have to be prepared and ready to share the gospel of Jesus Christ. And you have to be ready just like that. And guess what? You don't have to do all the work, but some of the work. The word of God says, some plant, some water, but God giveth the increase. Love them to life through Jesus Christ, because guess what? Jesus wants them to. He reminded us in a song, it said, when I look back over my life and think things over, I can truly say that I've been blessed. Guess what? I've got a testimony. He reminded us in just a reference, Revelation 12 and 11. Just make a note, jot it down. And by the word of their testimony, and they love not their lives unto death. I said, thank God, because as they overcome, we have overcome, become overcomers by the blood of the Lamb. Thank God for Jesus Christ. He reminded us in a song as we continue to run the race with purpose. He said, saints of God, people of God, I must run on in this holy race. I must run on until I see God's face. I must run on through the storms and the rain. I must run on through sorrow and pain. I must run on as though I lose my best friend. I must run on. I know I'll win in the end with wings on my feet and fire in my bones until I hear him say, well done. Guess what? Something beautiful, something good. All my confusion, your confusion, he understood. All I had to offer him was brokenness and strife. And guess what? Jesus made something beautiful out of my life. He gave us a quick acronym, RACE, R-A-C-E. We all must run our race with purpose and patience. However, we as believers in Jesus Christ, 4 points. RACE, the R stands for run. 2, the second one stands for as. 3 stands for Christ. And the 4th point stands for examples. We have to run as Christ's examples. Today, the change that he's made in our lives, and we run our race with purpose and patience, we must run as Christ's examples. It was an old worldly song that says, I always feel like somebody watching me. Well, guess what? They are watching you and me too. And we have to live a life that's pleasing in God's sight. And we can truly say today, thank God for the change. Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 through 20 reminds us. It talks about the Great Commission. It says, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the world. And guess what? He reminds us, scripture says in Proverbs 11 and 30, just make a note. It says, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. We want to continue to learn. Make a quick note again. 5 quick points to share in evangelism, in times like these. It's not about me. It's not about you. It's about Jesus. And it's all about the gospel being spread of Jesus Christ. First point, the birth. Second point, the life. Third point, the death. Fourth point, the resurrection. Fifth point, the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He's coming back real soon. First point, the birth. Second, the life. Third, the death. Fourth, the resurrection. Fifth, the second coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the King of Kings. He reminded us, living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified, freed me forever. One day he's coming back. What a glorious day. We have to be about the work of Jesus Christ. He reminds us the gospel. Where is the gospel found, minister? Teach me that. It's being taught right now. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, use verse 1 through 4. Equip yourself with it. Study it. Know where it's found. 1 Corinthians 15, verses 1 through 4. Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, but which also ye are saved. Thank you, Lord. If you keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. Verse 3 says, for I delivered unto you, thank you, first of all, that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Somebody say, thank God for the gospel of Jesus Christ. I need to make a note of that, that now I can go back and reference that. 1 Corinthians 15, starting at verse 1 through 4. But yet when we were dead in our trespasses, you saying that somebody came and reached down and saved us? Where's that found at? Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians chapter 2, start at verse 1 and we going through 10. What's it say, minister? It says, and you hath he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sins, wherein in times past ye walked. Well, in times past, we all walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the powers of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience. Lord Jesus, among whom also we all had our conversations in time past, in the lusts of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But verse 4 says what? But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, wherewith he loved us, he loved you, he loved me, even when we were dead in sins, hath quickened us together, hallelujah, with Christ. By grace ye are saved, and hath raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness toward us through Christ Jesus. Verse 8 said, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift. Thank God for the gift of God, not of works. Can't buy your way in. Can't use your credentials to get you in, lest any man should boast. It says, not of works, and not of who you know, but whom you are of. And that's Jesus Christ our Lord. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. Lord Jesus, the Lord said, but teach him a quick lesson. The lesson is found in Luke 15, 1 through 7. What's it say, evangelist? It says, then draw near unto him all the publicans and sinners for to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured. The ones that should have been murmuring, and guess what? They were murmuring and saying, this man receiveth sinners and eateth with them. And he spake this parable unto them, saying, what man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lost one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after that which is lost until he find it? And when he has found it, he layeth it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors. He's calling his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep, which was lost. I say unto you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth, more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance. Yes, saints, for we are the light of the world. Just make a note, Matthew 5 and 14, ye are the light of the world. A city is set on a hill cannot be hid, neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light, my light, our light, so shine before men, women, boy, girls, and children, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father, which is in heaven. Help wanted. Jesus is calling you today. And guess what? He reminded us in Isaiah 53 and 5, but he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of his peace was upon him, and with his stripes, hallelujah, we are healed. And now it's time to go and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. But if I can, you can help somebody else along the way. Our living shall not be in vain. Saints of God, keep running your race with purpose, with patience. And it does get hard sometimes. But we, the saints of God, have to cross the finish line of our individual races. We have to be able to obtain our own rewards. And we will be counted. Yes, sir. Yes, 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 saints of God, people of God, we will be counted one day. And guess what? And held accountable. For we know that the race is not given to the swift, neither is the battle to the strong, but to them that endure to the end. And just when you think you're getting tired and we need to strap up and put on the full armor of God, he said, give them Acts 1 and 8. Remind them, the saints of God, the people of God, as we prepare to go and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. Acts 1 and 8 says, but ye shall receive power. How many people need the power of the Holy Ghost today? With all of these troubles and craziness going on in this world, you got to be covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. And we need power, Holy Ghost power. Do they say Holy Ghost power anymore? Yes, Holy Ghost power. After that, the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. It's time to take the gospel to the world. For we, Father God, have been called by you to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. And yet, we have to remind the lost, the last, the least, as St. John 3 and 7 says, marvel not that I say unto thee, listen, ye must be born again. Somebody needs Jesus. Somebody is lost and trying to be found. They see this sign that says help wanted, and they see that Jesus wants them and needs them, but there's a requirement. It says, marvel not that I say unto thee, ye must be born again. And yet, once you've been born again and you walk up with Jesus Christ, you know, saints of God, he reminds us that Christ has made us free. And be not entangled again in the yoke of bondage. Once he brought you out, we're going to stay out. And yet we know that Jesus is the only one that will keep us. He is the only one that will help us in times like these. But yet we know Romans 5 and 8 reminded us, but God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Evangelist style, loving them into the arms of Jesus Christ. You got to know St. John 3:16 and 17. What's it say, evangelist? It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. 17 is the verse of compassion. For God sent not his son, compassion, into the world to condemn the world. Thank you, Lord. But that the world, through him, might be saved. For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you are listening tonight, and you don't know Jesus, and you don't have a personal, active relationship with Jesus Christ, don't get caught dead without Jesus. There is a heaven, and there is a hell, and we want to go to heaven. We want to stand before him, and we want to see his righteousness. We are covered and being washed each and every day by the blood of Jesus Christ. And guess what? He wants you. He's saying, help wanted. Come to the cross. No more slipping, sliding, peeping, and creeping. Come and I will give you rest. And yet, we need rest. Matthew 11, 28 and 29 says, come unto me, all ye that labored and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your soul. If you're here tonight and you haven't asked Jesus Christ to come into your life and you don't have your own personal active relationship. Not talking about mama, grandma. Yeah, look, I thank God for the Eunice and the Lois in my life. St. Thelma Duckett, St. Joyce E. Taylor would have me by the hand when they were out in the streets doing evangelism, passing out tracts, spreading the happy news, telling other people about Jesus Christ. You have some of those folks that you can remember that were examples, and not just talking about it, but we're living it and we're actively working to bring souls to Christ. And thank God that I came to my senses one day. I finally got sick and tired of being sick and tired. I got tired of the room spinning. And look, and Sister Ingrid said, don't come home again from happy hour and you not be happy. Well, guess what? Saturday night, I'm in church and Jesus has made me glad. And I'm so happy that I accepted him. I believe in him and Christ has made me free. He said, a new creature has been created in me in Christ Jesus. For old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. And guess what? Help wanted. Jesus wants you to. If you don't have a personal active relationship with Jesus Christ, and if you have, and you got a little twist in it off track, just pray this prayer with me tonight. Just pray this with me. I'm throwing out the lifeline that Jesus Christ gave me. Just say, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I repent of all my sins, all my stuff. And Lord, I believe that you are my Savior and Lord and my soon coming King. Lord, I accept you into my heart. Now make the change and do, Lord, oh, do, Lord, please remember me. Welcome into the body of Christ. There's more work that needs to be done, more teaching, more discipleship now that has to go forth. But yet the Lord will have you connect back with us, and we will give you the information that you need to equip you as you continue to run your race in Jesus Christ. Family of God, we need each other, and we are helpless one to another. We all are pressing, trying to make heaven our home. We are running our race with purpose and patience, and we don't want to leave anybody behind. Jesus wants you. He said, help wanted. Now what we need to do is seek the Lord. The Lord gave me a tool. As I go out in the streets, as I go out in the highways and the byways, this is the tool that he gave me. As a evangelist, as missionaries, as disciples out on the streets and the highways and the byways and the stores and places that people need the gospel of Jesus Christ. I sought him way back in 2005 and 6, and this is the tool that God gave me to use. And as many missionaries and other evangelists and pastors and teachers that have picked up that tool, but yet God will give you your own personal tool. Ask them what track, what paper, what is it that I can have readily in my hand that I can share the gospel. But you have to read it first for yourself and study it before you can help somebody else. As you, and as I bring it into a close, take the gospel to the streets, be wise and be covered, and yet run your race. For you are the church, because it's not about the brick and mortar buildings anymore. And guess what? One day we ought to hear the Lord say, 2 Timothy 4:7-8, I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, with the Lord and the righteous judge shall give me at that day. And guess what? Not to me only, but unto all them also that love his appearing. There is a heaven and there is a hell, one made for those who accept and one made for those who reject Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Evangelist Taylor is reminding you, don't be caught dead without Jesus. Run as Christ's examples. Run according to Christ's expectations of you, because I'm running, guess how? With wings on my feet and fire in my bones, until I hear him say, well done. We are the gospel spreaders. Guess what? Help wanted. Jesus wants you. May God bless you.